Well, good evening and a warm welcome to you and a warm welcome to those who are watching at home. We had a slight technical, so that's why we're smiling here. Let's start with this call to worship. Our God is at work in the world, spreading love, joy, peace and hope. Let us learn to see where God is at work and tend the seeds that God has sown. We pray, Heavenly Father, you are a generous, loving God. Show us your work, reveal your character, and shape our lives, that we might follow your pattern and share in your harvest. Amen. We use this song, Come On and Celebrate, and I think most people will know it. If you don't, please just listen to it and join in as you get to know it.
Same day, Jesus left the house and sat beside the lake. A large crowd soon gathered around him, so he got into a boat. Then he sat there and taught as the people stood on the shore. He told many stories in the form of parables, such as this one. Listen, A farmer went out to plant some seeds. As he scattered them across his field, some seeds fell on a footpath, and the birds came and ate them. Other seeds fell on shallow soil with underlying rock. The seeds sprouted quickly because the soil was shallow, but the plants soon wilted under the hot sun, and since they didn't have deep roots, they died. Other seeds fell among thorns that grew up and choked out the tender plants. Still other seeds fell on fertile soil, and they produced a crop that was 30, 60, and even 100 times as much as has been planted. Anyone with ears to hear should listen and understand. Now listen to the explanation of the parable about the farmer planting seeds. The seeds that fell on the footpath represent those who hear the message about the kingdom and don't understand it. Then the evil one comes and snatches away the seed that was planted in their hearts. The seed on the rocky soil represents those who hear the message and immediately receive it with joy. But since they don't have deep roots, they don't last long. They fall away as soon as they have problems or are persecuted for believing God's word. The seed that fell among the thorns represents those who hear God's word, but all too quickly the message is crowded out by the worries of this life and the lure of wealth, so no fruit is produced. The seed that fell on good soil represents those who truly hear and understand God's word and produce a harvest of 30, 60, or even 100 times as much as has been planted.
Dear Lord, we ask as we think about your teaching and the teaching of Scripture. On Sunday, I was talking about how we understand parables and how we use parables, and the fact that parables enable us to engage with the story in whatever level we feel, whatever point that story touches us, which enables that story to be relevant and effective at any time or in any place. But more about that we are responding in the right way to God and the right way to what he wants. A parable of how we try to do it. But as we look at this parable, we see that that open. To produce fruit. Be sure that Jesus was saying, if you don't understand it, you're nowhere. If you do understand it, you're going to get somewhere. So how do we understand? How do we understand what is there. Clearly, we need help, and we need help who've interpreted before, those who have thought through, the help of God. We need to make sure that what we're doing is the way that it should be done. One of the of understanding it. We have a bigger view. A fruit and harvest. But I think the scripture would represents those
good to have this song, Christ Be In My Waking, to ask God to be there, maybe taking away the worries or helping us in other ways. It's a version of the St. Patrick's Prayer, and we, I think, have used it before and people will be used to it.
Thank you.
When the Lord comes, he will bring to light the things now hidden in darkness and will disclose the purposes of the heart. Therefore, in the light of Christ, let us admit our failures and weaknesses. Lord, we confess we are slow to tend the soil of our souls. Help us to prepare ourselves as we would prepare our gardens for planting. Let us contemplate the rocks that hinder growth. Help us gather them and cast them out. Let us consider the thorns that choke new growth. Help us root out all the things that smother God's word. Like soil turned over and ready to receive, we have confessed our shortcomings and await the sowing of your seed. Meet us, sow in us, and nurture your growth. Amen.
We thank you, God, that we can turn ourselves around like bad soil made good. By turning it over and tending, we can be ready to receive you. We thank you that you put the past in the past and treat us as fully renewed. May we patiently wait for your growth, knowing you will tend and feed us. Amen.
Lord God, we pray today for all the people given the great privilege of spreading your good news. We pray for the church worldwide, but in particular in the places where people are still persecuted for their beliefs. We pray for our ministers who prayerfully seek your face and bring us the words and understanding we need to become more faithful followers of you. We pray for writers and poets as they pore over your word and seek the guidance of the Holy Spirit to bring your message to life on the page. We pray for artists and all craftspeople who draw inspiration from your word and speak to us through their creations. Amen.
Amen.
We pray together. Our Dad in heaven above, let everyone look up to you and the area where you are in charge grow. May what you want happen on earth as perfectly as it does in heaven. Please give to us what we need for today. Forgive us when we think or do wrong things, just as we don't hold it against those who hurt us. Guide us away from whatever we might want, but is unhelpful to us, and protect us from all that is nasty and destructive. For you are in charge of everything. You have the power to do it, and you are awesome. You always were, you are now, and always will be. Amen. Our final song is I Am a New Creation. And we sing this, or again, listen to it as we choose.
Let's say this final prayer together. ever-giving God, we thank you that you have never stopped sowing your word among us. Give us receptive hearts and make us fruitful for you in the week to come. Amen.
May your heart be at peace and your mind be at rest. May you be confident in who you are and share God's gifts of light, hope and grace with those you meet and those you pray for. And may the blessing of God fill your hearts with hope this day and evermore.